Who here has broken a bone before?
And the winner of the 3 minute thesis is...
3MT and the postdoc spotlight are both excellent professional development for the graduate students and scholars who participate. They go through this transformation from when they come in on day one at the plenary coaching session and they have a draft of their talk, they have impressive research findings that they want to share but aren't necessarily equipped with the skills to communicate those to a general audience. And then they go through small group coaching sessions where they get feedback from each other.
There's so much really cool research going on in Stony Brook, and I love that this event focuses on bringing these very technical ideas and making it clear to a general audience, including myself. And so I was just excited to take on that challenge.
I think that the lessons that we learn here are eventually going to be conveyed in the papers we write, the articles we write. Now we know that those details are crucial in order to really convey an important story.
From the first session to the second session, I think I learned how to navigate through different tools like the stage presence and then how to talk about my passion. Even though I'm passionate, sometimes I would feel like, in front of a wider audience, I would feel like very nervous. So I think I learned, even though I feel nervous, I know I can take a deep breath and then just go forward.
Coming in felt a bit daunting because I love the work that I do, but I've never had a chance to explain my work to a general audience. I feel like when I'm explaining work, even to my parents, they don't understand what I'm doing. So I thought this was a great opportunity to really deconstruct my ideas and my work. I feel like there's a lot of value in what I do, and I really want people to see that and get excited by my work too. Thank you.
So the coaching sessions are quite intensive. We spend hours together and we look at every second of that 3 minute talk to make sure that it's as refined as possible, that we really hone and distill their message. And then to today's dress rehearsal, when they are so confident, they're using the stage so well, they're communicating their findings, not just through their words, but through their body language, through the image that they showcase on the screen. It's so great to see them kind of come into that level of confidence about their work.
All of this exercise, I think, is great because one, you're challenging yourself, and two, you get to tell the world about what you're doing and explain it in a way that you can make other people care about it. Because a lot of the times we get bogged down in like the really tiny details of our research and we don't see the big picture.
We've gotten to meet every week and we've gotten to practice our talks, gotten really good feedback that I think is helpful not only for the 3MT competition, but also just in speaking in general, which is something that I'm going to do a lot as an academic. And so I think it's advice that I'm going to be able to carry throughout my career.
I wanted to do this to build my confidence and to be able to talk to people in larger settings, and this is like a nice stepping stone to get there. I think I'll still be nervous for Friday no matter what, but I know that I'm going to come in there with full confidence because I practiced a lot on this.
And then, this is Saya Abasol.
Thank you.